How do I transfer purchased software to my new machine? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I want to buy a new laptop. Can I transfer the programs from my Dell desktop to the new laptop? Things like Microsoft Office, Windows Media, etc. Or do I need to buy this software again? So, as always, the answer really is, it depends. But for the most part, it is extremely rare that you would have to purchase the software again if you are moving from one machine to another. Let's go over exactly what steps you might need to take in order to move your software to your new machine, and then talk about what some of those exceptions might be where potentially needing to purchase another copy or another license might be part of the equation. Unfortunately, by far, the best way to transfer software to your new machine is to get the installation media for that software, be it a physical DVD or a USB stick or a download that you've saved or a download that you get again, and then reinstall the software from scratch. I'll talk about some of the alternatives that aren't quite as severe, but honestly, this is the method that I recommend 99% of the time. Install the software on the new machine from scratch, activate it as need be, and then copy over your data from the older machine. That will get you the most stable and typically the most current version of that software ready to run on your new machine. Like I said, you will have to transfer your data files one way or another. That can be a copy from the old machine. It can be a restoration from backups. It can be all sorts of different approaches. That's really up to you and how you manage your data. There are some programs that will allow you to copy over initialization files. Sometimes they are literally any file. Sometimes they are other kinds of files. So if you happen to have one of those programs, and unfortunately I don't have a way to tell you whether or not you have one of those programs, you'll need to find those files and then copy them to the equivalent place on the new machine. It is possible if you do that, that you will then copy all of your settings and other configuration nuances to the new machine. It's uncommon, but it's possible. Now, whenever I talk about migrating software from one machine to another, I get several recommendations, several comments that say, hey, there's a bunch of migration tools out there that will supposedly do this for you. Software that somehow understands how these programs are installed on one machine and are able to copy them over to a new machine. Yep, those programs exist. Some are good, some are not, and ultimately, your success or failure also depends on the complexity of the software that you're trying to move. The more complex, and it may not appear complex to you, it may be a simple program for you to use, but if the installation, if how the installation of that software is handled is complex, it's in multiple folders, it's in multiple places in the registry, there's files that are dropped all over the place, then the migration tools have a lower chance of succeeding. I tend to avoid them, mostly because it's not uncommon for the result of such a migration to be less than successful, less than 100% successful. It can work, but you just don't know for certain. So it is one of those things where, yes, if you want to try it, by all means, go ahead and try it. You'll be paying some money, but don't be surprised if the results are somewhat less than stable. Like I said, installing from scratch avoids all that, and it's free. Another approach is cloning software. Now, this is actually a really big stick for this problem that I strongly don't recommend, but I do want to mention it because some people have had some success with it. By cloning software, I mean you're actually cloning the entire hard disk from the old machine and then restoring it to the new machine. So everything that's on the old machine will then appear on the new machine. Your software, your installed software, your settings, your old operating system, everything. There are two problems with that. One, especially if you've had your machine for a while, it's often a downgrade. In other words, your new machine probably came with the most current version of the operating system. Today, that's Windows 11. If you've got an old machine that you've been using for a while, it's probably running Windows 10. Imaging that machine using backup software or cloning software, and then restoring that image to your new machine will cause Windows 11 then to be completely overwritten and replaced with Windows 10. And it suffers from the same problem I was talking about with the application transfer tools, and that is it is often less than stable. It can work, it can appear to work, but it can also have underlying problems. So it is something that I don't actually recommend. Now, there are two scenarios where there's an opportunity for you to improve the scenario next time, and a scenario where you don't need to do a thing. The first one is portable apps. This is a wonderful opportunity for you to see if there is a portable app or a portable app equivalent for whatever it is you're using. Portable apps, by definition, are designed to do exactly what we're trying to do here. They are designed to be easily copied from one machine to another. They don't have a setup, usually, and they don't install themselves so intrusively as most setup programs do. What that means is, well, you can actually run many of these portable apps from a USB stick if you want to. But it does mean that you can copy them to your hard disk. Literally, installing is copying to your hard disk and just using them right then and there. This is a fine opportunity to see if maybe some of the apps you care about either have portable versions, or if it's worth it to you, you might consider switching to equivalent applications that do have portable versions. Personally, I'm happy with setup programs. I really am, because again, I keep going back to setting it up from scratch. But if this is something that is interesting to you, look for portable versions of whatever it is you use. And finally, so much of what we do these days is online. Email, for example, there are free versions of Office tools, word processors, spreadsheets, and so forth. Those are all online. Your files are all stored online, but the application is all still online. For those, you don't need to do a thing. You just move to your new machine, fire up your web browser, sign into whatever service that is, and you're good to go. Everything you were working on is still there. So that's another alternative, is to actually have all of your work online so that you can access it not only from the old computer and the new computer, but whatever computer you happen to have available to you whenever you need to do so. So there are lots of options. Unfortunately, I do believe strongly that a reinstall of the application is by far the best, safest, and most efficient way to go. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/130561. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.